Good morning. Okay, hi. So, first and foremost, of course, I want to thank Pastor and the Pastor team for giving me this honor to share with you guys actually a message for today. So, if hindi nyo din alam, it's Grandparents Day. So, to all the grandparents, happy Grandparents Day. So, actually, ako nga pala. So, ayun. So, today, my message is actually the importance of a grandparent. So, before I begin, just to tell you guys a short background, di ko alam bakit ako pinili ni Pastor. Feeling ko si God na talaga nag-talaga kay Pastor. this is, I think, a month ago. Pastor came to me and said, JR, gusto mo mag-speak for Grandparents Day? And gusto ko actually mag-know. Actually, sabi ko, ayoko eh. Kasi usually, nandun lang ako sa tabi. Dun lang ako nagda-drums. Usually, I'm not usually up here. Sabi ko nga kay Pas, it's going to be my first time in front of you guys. Well, second time. Ganun lang sa first time ko eh. So, sa first service. But for me, I said, why not? Sige, let's give it a chance because it doesn't really matter actually for me. I've learned all throughout siguro the walk with the Lord that it doesn't really matter who's up here. For me, it matters actually is just that the message of the Lord. So vessels lang talaga kaming lahat kung sino man nandito, whether it may be me or siguro nagiging si JM at some point or si Kuya Gino. It can be anyone. Mas bata pa nga sa akin, pwede pa eh. Pero yeah, the Lord is just using us siguro for a way to deliver something to all of you and to bless you guys. So before I begin, so I would love to pray for everyone so that ma-receive natin yung blessing of the Lord today. So let's pray. Lord God, thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for this wonderful service that I will be able to share to your people, Lord God, the message of what is the importance of a grandparent, Lord God. And I pray, Lord God, that the people here would not just see me as a young individual, but as a vessel for blessing in their life moving forward, Lord God. And I pray, Lord, that whatever may come out from my mouth, Lord God, it will be you telling them something to apply in their lives as well. And Lord, thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for all the grandparents who are here today, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, so actually, before I start, yun nga, I actually have one verse, yun nga, a while ago, just to share an experience. If you guys heard of the band called Planet Shakers, it's it's a band that sobrang sikat na siya ngayon. The reason why actually I said yes to Pastor, kasi naalala ko, it was a conference here in the Philippines, nag-attend ako, and there was one speaker in that conference, surprisingly, drummer siya. Sabi ko, okay, ang cool naman nun, yung drummer mag-speak. Usually, that doesn't happen a lot. Tapos, yun pala, nung nag-introduce siya, pastor din siya. Sabi ko, ibang klase din to, pastor pala yung drummer. So, okay, hindi naman sinasabing magiging pastor din ako. Pero, sabi ko lang, doesn't really need to be someone na nagiging pastor para lang magsalata dito. So, I found a verse in the Bible which reminded me na it's found in 1 Timothy 4. Wala siya sa slides ko. But it says, 1 Timothy 4:12, do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in life, in love, and faith, and in purity. So, for everyone here, yun nga, I just took this opportunity because yun nga, sayang lang din naman. And it's God's grace using me to bless other individuals today. So, yun nga, going to my message proper. So, it's the importance of a grandparent. Obviously, we're here to say thank you or appreciate our grandparents. So, if you do not know my Lola, ayan, that's her. But she's also in front right now. So, everyone knows, or majority of the church knows her by the name Tita Vanjie. And for me, I really believe she is one of the most generous and loving individual that I know. As in, to a point that she blesses others kahit hindi niya kakilala. Which is, I think, a normal characteristic of a grandparent. Kaya nakakatuwa talaga si yung lola ko. kasi si ano pa yun. It's really nice to see people, of course, blessing other individuals kahit hindi talaga magkakilala. And obviously, she wouldn't be a grandparent if walang apo. So, So these are all of us actually combined. If you do not see them, it's because tatlo lang talaga kami dito sa Pilipinas. Me, JB, and JT, if you know my brothers. And the rest are all in the States or wherever they may be. Narinig ko kung saan-saan din saan nakarating. So, we all have different walks. We all have different walks in life. But we're very, very, I think I can speak on behalf of all of them. We're very, very proud to say that we have one thing in common, which is obviously we love our Lola. Ganun talaga siya. Yun yung nakakatawa kasi, let's say, me and my brother are working already. JT is still in school. Two of them are actually married. One is with the kid. One is, I think, traveling the world and learning new things with new educational backgrounds and stuff. So, ang dami talaga namin ginagawa. But for us, especially yun wala sa Pilipinas, they always try to do their best to communicate back here in the Philippines sa Lola. They send letters, written ones pa. Hindi, ayaw nila ata email. Di ko alam bakit. Email, ayaw nila. I think text message hindi talaga kaya. But they send written letters, which I hear from my Lola saying na this is what's happening, especially nung isang cousin ko na magiging wife na siya na isang guy. Sabi ko, mas bata pa siya sa akin. Sabi ko, ang lupit naman ito. Okay, sige, no problem. Pero knew it only through a letter, ha? Send letter pa siya. So, yeah, but everyone here, of course, everyone here has their own grandparents or lolas and lolos. And today, that's why I've prepared actually 3 points, how we can actually say that these grandparents are important in our life. Yeah, so, the first point, grandparents are here to inspire us. Okay? So, our grandparents are here to inspire us every single day. Lagi yung favorite line, I think most of, maybe may yung mga ibang tao dito, especially pag may grandparents, usually there's a joke na sinasabi na, nung panahon ko, ganito kasi lagi, or ganyan nagsimula yung lola at lola ko. Mga ganyan yung kasabihan. And they always bring up these things to inspire us every day na hindi naman talaga tayo directly affected. But naalala pa rin natin yun, grandparents natin. Even in a joking way pa rin, lola ko yan. Parang ganun siya. But they use their wisdom and their experiences in life to help us learn life lessons as well for ourselves, especially kami as grandkids. So, they have gone through so much things, I'm pretty sure, with their age naman. But they want to, of course, give us like a shortcut in a way. Obviously, everyone has challenges in life, but they want us to have an easier way. Hindi man siguro may experience lahat, but trying to cut down siguro of what we can actually avoid moving forward, especially to give us a message. Na we're always there for you. Don't worry. This is what you can do so that you can avoid all these things. So they love to inspire us, talaga, and it says actually in Psalm 71:18 that now that I am old and gray, do not abandon me, O God. So let me proclaim your power to this new generation, your mighty miracles to all who come after me. And our grandparents are always the people who love seeing their grandkids excel. Sobrang tuwa nila, kahit nung bata kayo, I'm pretty sure, kahit perfect attendance yan, wow, ang galing mo talaga. Perfect attendance lang. kahit alam mo, okay lang yun. Perfect attendance lang naman. Pero sila sobrang supportive pa rin to every extent. They just want to actually give inspiration to you that they're always there for you as well. They live a life that that is God-fearing. Hearing the scripture from them is also a good thing because they also want us to make sure that we grow up as godly children. Of course. And nakakatawa yun sayings na every single day, they try to bless us with different kinds of inspirational quotes or whenever you meet them, whether weekends lang or siguro kahit pag-uwi niyo from work or from school, they always try to say something that will try to help you out even if, alam mo parang, hindi ako yung narinig ko na yan. Pero if you think of it, actually, They're just there to make sure that you don't feel negative. You don't feel disappointed. Nawawala yung disappointment. They would just want to be an inspiration in your life. Because obviously we have parents. I have my own parent, of course. But they're a, what do you call this? A second parent saying they're always there for you, and yung love nila mas malakas. Kasi mas mahaba siya. It goes down to two generations. So the first generation, of course, is your parents. Then the next one is, yan, kami. Kami na, yung mga apo. So that's what actually leads me to my second part. So our grandparents actually also love us extraordinarily to a point hindi mo maintindihan. Kahit nag-U-turn kayo, nag-left turn, nag-right turn sa path nyo, they still love you for who you are. It's a special kind of love that we always say that whichever path you take in your career, they're going full support. Sila yung parang cheerleader kasi yung parents daw. Sila yung gives you advice. Okay, baka it's not the best for you. Okay, maybe that's the best for you. Pero sila talaga kahit anong gawin mo, sige, go lang. Basta masaya ka, go lang. Yay! Ganun. And it's a good feeling, of course, from our grandparents knowing that they love us so much. You know, unconditional love is always there, just like the Lord has given to every one of us. But for yung mga lolos, mga lolas, ibang klase talaga siya. Kasi minsan, most of you might not live with your lolos or lolas anymore. But every time you see them, parang, bagong baby ka, kakalabas lang, sobrang ngiti sila lagi. Uy, nandito ko ulit eh. Ganun lang sila. So, actually, I found a scripture also. It says in Psalms 92. So, but the godly will flourish like palm trees, growing strong like the cedars of Lebanon. Even in the old age, they will still produce fruit. They will remain vital and green. They will declare, the Lord is just. He is my rock. There is no evil in him. So, yun cedars, actually, it's a part of the plant family, but it's a tree in general. It's a tree. But ganun yun love ng mga grandparents. It's sobrang lakas na hindi lang basta-basta mo nawawala. Kahit may mali kang ginawa, mahal ka pa rin nila. And sobrang pure lang siya, pure and fresh, that they have no intention na, even if alam ko medyo mali siya, like if you don't try to love them back, kahit pa paano, they will still love you. They will love you every single way. They will even if it's not direct, they will try to do their best to show you the love. Even just through a smile. Yun nga, yung smile talaga nila, parang pag nakita ka lagi, ibang klase. Parang first time ka nakita. Every single day. Pero nakikita naman kayo lagi. Every weekend. Or kahit nasa isang bahay. Kaya nakakatuwa lang din. So, it's also having the love for them. It's extraordinary because they have an inspiring faith. Lagi sila yung tao na nagbe-bless ng ibang tao. As I mentioned, my lola just blesses other people. I'm pretty sure even if hindi niya kakalala. They just want to make sure that we feel loved every single day. And ako personally, I talk to a lot of people every day and I meet mga lolos, mga lolas. Sila talaga yung love nila for their grandkids. Kung pwede lang talaga makipag-usap ng buong araw just about their grandkids, gagawin nila yun. I'm pretty sure. And I think my lola can do the same. So, kahit siguro dalawa lang yun, apo, siguro one per day, pwede na. Okay na yun sa kanila. But that's how strong their love is. They can tell so much about how they love their grandkids. To extent, kahit wala naman sila masabi, gagawin nila ng paraan para lang may masabi sila. Ganun lang. So, and that leads me to the third point. So, for the grandparents, they also want to make sure that they want to make a legacy. So, our grandparents have lived a life already, and I'm pretty sure their main goal naman talaga is to make sure they live a life that is well worth living for other individuals. Pag nakita ka, pag nakita sila ng ibang family members, this is the legacy that my lola left. This is my lola. This is the legacy that my lola left. And I'm pretty sure people my age also did the same, are doing the same. Like if we ask ourselves, What is the legacy you want to live for your future family? Maisip namin, and I'm pretty sure they would think so much things already, since they have so much experience in their life, they have so much challenges na na overcome. It's just being also a godly example for us, having that strong faith. So they make a legacy by living a life of integrity, both public and private. So not just here in the church, kasi obviously pag dito sobrang bait, but yung maglabas, kailangan din, they have to carry that legacy for themselves, or that faith of themselves na even if I'm outside this four walls of the church, ganun pa rin sila. They still bless others. They still try to inspire us. They still try to inspire other individuals. And they want to make the legacy that pag siguro, I'm pretty sure if, knock on wood, but once they join the Lord, parang, I remember the Lord. I remember the Lord because my lola has inspired me into this way. Yun yung iniwan na legacy sa akin. They set the pace for us. Yeah, they set the pace for us moving forward. They want to make sure that we follow a path, right? Kaya I find most mga grandkids, the reason why kahit saan sa mundo, whichever faith or religion, you can see the reason why the kids are in this kind of faith is because of usually it starts with the grandparents. It goes down the line. As in, pag Kristiyano, ganun talaga. Pag Buddha, ganun talaga. Wala. Ganun talaga yun pathway na sinet out for the grandkids. So, they want to leave that path for everyone. Para sumunod lahat. So, it's a good thing for them to feel appreciated because they do so much that hindi naman talaga siya nakikita or it's indirect to all of us. But in a way, it plays a giant role in our lives if you actually think of it and move forward. And that's why nakakatawa talaga yung mga parts na they are actually also a role model. So they want us to walk with the Lord every single day. That's why they say blessings to us. Like, God bless you. Kahit sa labas ng church, they still give you verses. They still try to make sure that you are with the Lord in prayer. Do you know that this prayer will help you out? So let me pray for you. I know siguro you're not struggling, pero sa loob-loobo, nagsistruggle ka. I'll just pray for you anyways. These are the things na maliit na bagay na ginagawa ng lolos or lolas sa atin that we don't realize or we don't take that much time to think na parang, hindi, okay lang, ginagawa naman sa akin yan every time. Every weekend, every time we meet, normal na sa akin yung ganun. But we have to think of it as a way na they just really want to connect with you. Because yung, for us, of course, for us grandkids, yung direct connection naman talaga namin is like my mom, so parent, obviously. But they want to make an impact in your life as well. Because even if they don't see us every single day, they still care. And I found this quote actually in the internet. Before that, obviously. So, I found this quote as well. It's in Proverbs, so 27. So, the righteous man walks in integrity and his children are blessed after him. So, yun nga, as I mentioned, we just follow the footsteps of our grandparents because they want to be as transparent as possible to us. They don't want to hide anything. They want to keep, make sure that it's clear for the next generations to come that this is the path that I set out for you. So, nasa atin, of course. Nasa atin if you would love to take it. But if we do take it, I'm pretty sure we would be blessed enough. Yung nga, blessed after the legacy that our grandparents gave. So, yun nga, I found this quote. It's natuwa ako actually. So, God couldn't be everywhere and so He made grandparents. Natuwa ako sa na quote na to kasi in a way, it's weirdly true. Pang they are the instruments that God has put into our lives, even if we do not tell them actually the things that are happening, they know what to tell you. Yun biglaan na you need something in your life, tas biglang ibabless ka. So parang, wow, I needed that. Or prayer, or biglang may gusto kong isipin, or may iniisip ka na gusto mong gawin. You're not so sure, but you want enough a positive feedback from someone or affirmation from someone na gagawin mo siya. And then here comes along your lolo or lola telling you about certain things and biglang nag-align sa iniisip ng isang tao, ah, okay, pwede pala to. Baka yun yung sign ni Lord. Si Lola na nagsabi sa akin. So, these are very, very unique characteristics of our grandparents. Whatever may happen, they bless us in so many ways that you cannot actually imagine how many times siguro they've done a few things for you guys. On my case, especially, obviously, when I was little, I have wala akong kaalam-alam sa nangyayari sa buhay kasi ako, kailangan lang talaga masaya lang ako. You play around with friends, obviously, as a kid. Pero when I grew up, I knew that there were actually a stage in our family's life na medyo hindi naman talaga okay. And ginawa ng lahat on the side of the grandparents para lang maging okay lahat. As in, hindi maramdam namin yung mga apo na there's something wrong. And I think that's a good thing, a good characteristic also of a grandparent, that they want us to feel hindi naman kailangan mag-worry because they got our backs no matter what. Even if I hear lots of stories na kahit magkaawa yung parents, sinasabi nila okay lang, nandiyan naman si Lola, nandiyan naman si Lolo, sila yung backup ko. Yeah. So they always sided the grandparents at some point. A connection with a lot of mga grandkids and grandparents. It's a unbreakable one, they always say. And iba yung connection talaga. So we as grandkids, we always remember them because they give timely advices, and it's a way to say to ourselves that we should appreciate our grandparents. Sometimes, of course, since we don't see them every day, we have our own lives, obviously. But they just want to feel that they are also appreciated for what they're doing. They also want to feel that kahit yung mga small messages, like the small messages, I'm pretty sure a lot of people use phones, kahit anong phone man yan, may text message pa rin yan. Kahit a small text, I'm pretty sure they would be happy enough to see that they're hearing from you, because you know, they just love to feel the appreciation. They love to feel that they are still part of your life. Yun yung maganda sa Filipinos, actually. We are very family-oriented. Kahit anong celebration yan, or kahit anong event, sumasama ang lolo at lola. Dati di ko maintindihan, bakit lahat kasama yung buong pamilya? Pero it's culture for us, which is, I think, a good thing din naman. Because, of course, we wouldn't forget our grandparents moving forward. So, kahit birthday, graduation, kahit nanalo lang ng yung mga awards ng bata, birthday parties, nandun pa rin, kahit alam namin, bakit, anong gagawin ng lola dito? Eh, maglalaro lang naman kami. They just want to see us. They just want to see you. They just want to imagine and watch you, how you grew up. That's why, lagi ko na naisip, kaya nila talaga buhatin yung conversation. Basta, pag-usapan nila yung apo nila. As in, kayang-kaya talaga. Sigur, especially yung lola ko, siguro buong week kaya niya. Isang tao pa lang yun. Yeah, so, today is Grandparents Day. So, whatever, if you do have any plans for your grandparents, please do take time to appreciate them. Or especially if they are actually here today. Don't take it for granted. I always say, na don't wait for that time to come. Na yun talaga, that they join the Lord and be happy and tumatumbling na sila at lahat. But appreciate them here pa lang. Here pa lang on earth while they're giving you their best effort, their best time, and everything else that they can offer. Because, sabi ko nga, ibang klase yun pagmamahal nila to everyone. Kahit hindi nga kikilala, sabi ko. So, today is Grandparents Day, and I want you guys to enjoy the day, especially your grandparents. And of course, last but not least, I want to greet all the grandparents a happy Grandparents Day. So thank you so much. God bless everyone.